Ray was a nationalist scientist with a fire raging inside him since his childhood to see India in its former glory. He mentions many times in his autobiography that India was glorious, but the present Indians need to adapt and compete with the changing times. During the late 19th century, nations had started looking up towards establishing scientific institutions of research and technology. It was viewed that the wealth of a nation was dependent upon how it promotes and develops scientific thoughts in its society. In 1885, he took up part in an essay writing competition of the University of Edinburgh on the subject India before and after the mutiny. Though he did not get a prize in this competition, his effort was regarded as the nearest approach to the best. He described with a lot of courage and conviction how the British were perpetuating colonial exploitation in India, neglecting the development and education of its people. Ray distributed copies of his printed essay among the university students and general public with an appeal to take steps to free India from colonial bondage. He sent one copy to Sir John Bright, an open-minded and progressive parliamentarian, for his comments. Bright wrote a letter commending the article and permitted him to use the letter to publicize the contents of the essay. Ray was a part of the Swadeshi community who believed in self-reliance of India, modernizing education, ushering in the industrial revolution of Indian products, and teaching skills to students so that they can participate and compete with the fast changes occurring in the world. P.C. Ray closely affiliated himself with the National Council of Education, a pedagogic organization based upon the Swadeshi spirit with science, technology and industrialization as its foundation. NCE was founded by Satish Chandra Mukherjee along with Sri Aurobindo. In the year of 1921, the council planned expansion in the syllabus of engineering studies. Under the chairmanship of P.C. Ray, a syllabus revision committee was set up to introduce new streams. The new curriculum introduced chemical engineering besides mechanical and electrical. Later on, Ray was made the president of National Council of Education, Bengal. He was of the opinion that Indian students should learn new skills and techniques, and merely getting degrees will not suffice the modern era dawning upon the world. He inspired students to become self-reliant entrepreneurs and not keep running behind government jobs. Prafulla Ray believed in the principles of Gandhi and was a practicing Gandhian in daily life. When Mahatma Gandhi visited Calcutta in 1901 on the invitation of Gopal Krishna Gokhale, Prafulla Ray actively participated in making arrangements for Gandhi's first public appearance in Calcutta. When British rulers introduced the norms of separate election of Hindus and Muslims to the legislative forms, Congress remained indifferent to it. But Prafulla Chandra opposed the nationalism on the basis of religion. He criticized the opportunist policy of then Congress leadership, which he believed could lead to communal divide. Being a righteous person, and despite being a practicing Gandhian, Ray severely criticized Gandhiji for his blunder in Khilafat movement of 1919. During the decade of 1920s, Ray participated in the freedom movement and was attached with political fronts. Although he did not take part in active politics, he could not keep himself aloof from the freedom struggle sweeping through the nation at that time. In the 1920s, during the peak of the non-cooperation movement, Ray delivered the famous quote, "Science can afford to wait, but Swaraj cannot." Ray was vociferous in his support for Subhash Chandra Bose when the Congress was divided on the election of Netaji to the president's post, the second time in 1938. During the World War II, when Nazi Germany attacked Russia in 1941, Acharya Ray, along with prominent Indians, issued a manifesto urging Indians to express full sympathy and solidarity with USSR. Acharya P.C. Ray was the first signatory to the statement. He was also sympathetic towards the revolutionaries and would also make arrangements for their shelter and food at his factories. After his death, many revolutionaries and his colleagues mentioned his indirect support and help in manufacturing explosives. The government records of that time mention him as a revolutionary under the garb of a scientist.
In the later decades, Ray heavily criticized the British for their failure to understand the nationalist feelings of Indians, the progressive needs of young Indians, and cautioned the British that this would lead to inevitable anger against their administration.
The political and economical mayhem that they have created will cost them dearly. He was right in his observation, as can be seen from the fact that India gained independence within the next 10 years.